Prolific. Okay, the poem number five that we are taking today is Television by Roald Dahl. So let's get started and go straight away into the world of television. Right, so Roald Dahl is one of the most prolific modern writers. Prolific, you know? Anyone has the idea? What is basically prolific?
Mom, who produces many poems and stories?
Prolific basically stands for bountiful. Bountiful here, it means one who has many qualities. One who has many qualities. So Roald Dahl was not only a poet. He was one of the most bountiful of modern writers, one of most prolific, most versatile modern writers in English, and is well known as a children's author. And he was more concerned. Some people, you know, they are more attached to the children and they have more childishness left in them and they are more concerned with the children. So Roald Dahl is one of those poets who get himself associated with the children, and he is more concerned regarding the problems that children face. The poem Television is a famous poem of Dahl that advises and inspires to read books. And he is always advising the children, the kids, that you should read books. You should develop this habit of reading books in you. And when you must have heard about Francis Bacon, he is also one of the most famous essayists of English. His famous proverb is that, reading makes a full man, conference a ready man, and writing an exact man. And if you want to be a writer, then first of all, reading should be your priority, because this only can enhance your vocab, your understanding, and it just elaborates your creativity. Instead of watching the television, when you watch the television, temporarily our brain stops functioning. We are just sitting there like puppets. So this is one of the most relevant poems of our time. But you can replace here the television with the mobile phones. So we can say ki relevant poems hai, only the device should be changed. In place of television, you should think about the mobiles. The poem takes a comic look at a serious problem. So a comic look de rahi hai, bahut maze se padhaya hai isko. Problem bahut serious hai among young children today. It warns us about the dangers of watching television excessively. And it gives us, warns us that it is very dangerous to watch excessive time. If you are watching television, definitely it is very dangerous, because TV robs our mind. Robs means steals away our minds of power of imagination and creativity. We lose our creativity, we lose our imagination, and he advises us to read books. His priority advice is that we should read books, as it will enable us to discover deeper levels of joy, because it enables, it develops into us the ability to discover deeper levels of joy, find fulfillment in life. Ki zindagi mein hum kuch acha kare. Fulfillment means when you feel the satisfaction. Fulfillment here stands for the satisfaction, and open a whole world, an exciting world for us. और ये हमारे सामने ओपन करता है एक नई दुनिया, एक ऐसी एक्साइटिंग वर्ल्ड फॉर अस दैट गिव्स रीडिंग बुक्स दैट गिव्स यू अ फिनोमेना ऑफ डेवलपमेंट. द मेंटल एबिलिटीज डेवलप ऑटोमेटिकली एंड नेचुरली. बट आई वुड ऑल्सो लाइक टू शेयर विद यू द सेंट्रल आइडिया ऑफ दिस पोम. इन दिस पोम डाल विशेस टू वॉर्न रीडर्स अबाउट हाउ टेलीविजन कैन हैव द इफेक्ट ऑफ डलिंग चिल्ड्रंस माइंड. Dulling is making dull. He is just, the television has the habit of making children's mind dull and dumb. Watching television can make children unimaginative. It robs of their imaginating powers, prevent them from enjoying the fairy tales. Aur jo pariyon ki kahaniyan sunte the hum dadi se or from our mothers, or we used to read, then we simply leave it and just watch it in the form of a cartoon on the television. And they are supposed to like. Fairy tales, they should be the part of the childhood, but they have been sadly replaced by television, and we'll have to see what is fed by those people who are creating these senseless cartoons like सो मेनी कार्टून्स आर देयर आई थिंक डोरेमोन जैसे जिनका कोई सेंस ही नहीं है, सेंसलेस कार्टून्स है. ऑन द अदर हैंड रीडिंग इज अ गुड हैबिट फॉर चिल्ड्रन. यू कैन चूज वॉट यू वॉन्ट टू रीड. इट शार्पन्स देयर माइंड एंड इट इंट्रोड्यूसेस देम टू होल न्यू वर्ल्ड दे नेवर न्यू एक्जिस्टेड. सो इट इंट्रोड्यूसेस यू एक नई दुनिया में आपको लेकर जाता है एंड इट एक्सप्लोर्स अ न्यू होराइजन फॉर योर क्रिएटिविटी. Therefore, Dahl request parents to bring back the books they had read before the invention of television back into their homes. So it is a sincere advice from Roald Dahl that you should uninstall television from your homes and rather you should develop or you should install or you should make a wonderful library with multiple choices into your house. So now let's get started and read this poem. The idea is very clear, I guess, to everyone. Is it? What we are going to read? Resumed? Jyotsna?
Everyone? Yes, ma'am.
So, let's see. And finally, just going, we are going to enjoy this a lot. The most important thing we have learned so far as children are concerned is never, never, never let them near your television set. Or better, still just don't install the idiotic thing at all. The poet is very, very sarcastic in against the television in the very first stanza, and he says that most important thing, जो हमने सीखा है, we have learned, the सबसे important thing जो हमने सीखी है, so far as the children are concerned, so far as बच्चों का, if we consider children, is never, never let them near your television set. Please don't expose them to see excessive television, excessive timings. Should not be given to them to watch television. Or better still, better he says it is. It would be better if you just don't install, just don't bring this idiot box, idiotic thing. It is popularly television is also popularly known as idiot box. So don't bring this idiotic thing at all into your house. He is strictly against this. In almost every house we have seen, we have watched them gaping at the screen. So in almost, poet says, in almost every house, in every house we have seen, right, wherever the poet happens to go, he has seen that the children are watching. The what the gaping, gaping means just sitting like that, mouth opened and just staring. This is called the gaping. He just looking at that, open a, right, they're like zombies, they are sitting over there and just gaping at the screen. They are just looking at the screen and no creativity is there. Mind also stops working for that time when they are watching television. They loll and slop and lounge about. They are just sitting there and lazily around. They are just sitting there and laze around, just falling onto the this side and falling onto the other side like that. They are just killing their time and lounge about. Lounge about means sitting idly, doing nothing at all. They are just simply watching TV and gazing at this idiot box and just feeding clutter into their mind and stare until their eyes pop out. Like that, unki aankhein itni zyada wide open hoti hai ki they are just lost into that world only. So nothing is create, no creativity is going on, no imagination because already it is imagined by someone else. So where is the scope for the creativity of the children? It does not exist while watching television and stare till their eyes pop out and they just watch it for long hours. Pop out means for very long hours they keep on watching television. So now he's sharing his experience that last week in someone's place, we saw a dozen eyeballs on the floor. So it is another humorous exaggeration. We can say hyperbole is there, right? It is called hyperbole. Hyperbole means when you exaggerate the things. So last week, actually, I got to visit someone's place and we saw a dozen eyeballs on the floor. So they were just rolling around. Actually, he was saying that someone was sitting here, someone was sitting there and just looking at the television. They sit and stare and stare and sit. This is called repetition. Same, the phrase has been repeated. Sit and stare, stare and sit. This is called repetition. So they are just sitting and staring and sitting, doing nothing else until they are hypnotized by it. and it feels as if they are completely fascinated by it. Hypnotize it when you are controlled by someone else. When you lose control over senses, over your own senses, then we call it hypnotization, and that is what it happened. Until they are absolutely drunk with all their shocking, ghastly junk. So until, and they keep on watching it, until if, one more figure of speech I'm telling you. If the consecutive lines start with the same word, it has anaphora. Right? This is called anaphora. So until they are hypnotized by it, until they are absolutely drunk with all that shocking, ghastly junk. So they are completely lost into the world of television, and they lost all their creative zone. And they are absolutely drunk with all the shocking. Shocking is just numbing their mind, and ghastly is deadly. Deadly junk. Junk is, what is junk? Junk is basically useless. That jo kabad hai, jo rubbish hai, faltu, unnecessary cheeze jo hai, they are fed into their mind. Like Doraemon ka agar example le li, that he has that wo, machine something over his head and he's just starting. Koi bhi agar sab bachche aise udne lag.
Yes, ma'am, gadgets.
So this is all deadly rubbish that is fed into their minds. Getting my point? So you can connect it very nicely to your present day scenario as well. Oh yes. We know it keeps them still. Oh, yes. Yes. Now the poet reaches to the main point. Ki what is the reason why the children are allowed to see so much of television? The reason is that the parents need a break. The parents need some time for themselves. And when they used to make their children sit in front of the television, then they do not disturb them. No, they are just lost. Sometimes you see them, they are doing it like this. And the parents are free for their own work. So, oh yes, we know it keeps them still. It means they don't fight, right? They don't go outside. They don't move out of the house. And they just don't climb out the windowsill. Wo bahar nahi bhag rahe. Oh yes, it keeps them still. It means physically it makes them inactive, right? Again, they. Again, which figure of speech will be here?
Anaphora.
Right. So it is anaphora again. So yes, we know it keeps them still. What is it? What is it?
Ma'am, television.
Very good, Harshika. Television keeps them still because they are hypnotized by this device. Na, ye is machine ke saath. They are just hypnotized. Don't climb out the windowsill. So they do not do any physical activity. They do not fight among themselves. They do not ask for the things. They do not disturb the house. They never fight or kick or punch. Na wo fight karenge, na ek dusre ko kick karenge, and they do not even punch. They hit with fist yani smutti se punch karte ho. So ye bhi, you are not doing that. They leave you free to cook the lunch. Mother is also free. Mother is also very happy. Theek hai, I am free to cook the lunch. Otherwise, this child is going to disturb me. So mother is also happy in making her child sit in front of the television. Right, and wash the dishes and the sink. Means she is free to do her household chores. Right, the household chores she can do here by making her child busy doing his watching the television, and she is free to do her household chores.
But yes, ma'am.
Do you ever stop to think? Now this is a call for the parents. You as for parents. Did you ever stop to think? To wonder just exactly what this does to your beloved tot. Tot is the child. So here is the question mark. The poet is asking the parents a very blank question. Have you ever thought to wonder just exactly? You will be shocked to see that exactly what this television, this idiot box is doing to your beloved child. Right, then in capital letters, the poet has written his answer. So that he actually, it is with the intention of highlighting his will. It rots the sense in the head. It kills imagination dead. Rots means decay. It completely decays the sense in the head. Means it completely robs the child of his senses. It simply makes him paralytic. He just doesn't use his head. He is not using his body. He is not feeling hungry even. So what is the benefit that television is bringing to the kids? Nothing. It simply decays the sense in the head. It simply decays his sense of his brain, actually, his sense of thinking. Simply decaying it kills the imagination dead. And imagination hai, the most creative thing the children can do, because from the childhood, if the child is having the habit of thinking beyond the line, then also only he'll be able to do something good in his matured life. If that initiative is killed right since the childhood, then be sure the miracle doesn't happen overnight. It is a continuous perennial process that keeps on going. So just don't kill that initiative, right? Don't make him sit in front of the television and just don't rob him of his imagination, right? It clocks and clutters up the mind, and he is very, very sarcastic and scolding kind of tone the poet is following here. It clocks and clutters up the mind. It makes a child so dull and blind, he can no longer understand a fantasy, a fairyland. His brain becomes as soft as cheese. His powers of thinking rust and freeze. He cannot think, he only sees. So after every line, you can see this interjections. See, and this is called apostrophe. This figure of speech is called apostrophe, right? So it clogs and clutters. It fills and covers up something with untidy collection of things. Jaise drains clog ho jate, naliyan band ho jate, drains. So simply, bacche ka mind bhi fill ho jate hai. Because so many things are already fed. He's thinking about that Naughty or the Doraemon or the other, these PUBG and all, or whatever things. You see na, so many cartoons you watch. So he already itna fill ho gaya ki you cannot create a cartoon of your own. Agar aap chahun to as a comic character, if you want to create. So what it will be, the sum up of all the things which have already been fed in your mind. From where will come the genuine thoughts? From where? When it will be empty, you will be reading the book. And when you read the book, you create the image of your own, right? And when you already see, when you see an already created image, then you cannot bring the changes in that. Are you getting my point?
Resume? Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, poet is very bluntly saying that it simply covers the untidy collection into the mind of the young tots, into the young kids. It makes a child dull and blind. Blind in the sense that eyesight to be hongi hongi, that is sure, but blind in the sense of he goes beyond the zone of imagination. So it makes him dull. If you see any child who is busy on a phone these days, more than required time he is giving, then definitely he remains dull. Eyes remains tired all the time, and you feel yourself ki aap nahi soch pa rahe ho kuch bhi. So he can no longer understand a fantasy. Aur tab aap usko fantasy samjhane ki koshish karoge na, imagination, imaginative fiction, if you are letting him understand, then he will never understand, because usko itni habit hai har cheez TV par dekhne ki, that he will not open up these buds into his mind. They won't bloom. They will ye seeds hi nahi dale na mind mein. When the seeds of imagination will be sown, then only they will germinate into saplings and create new things. When the creation, when the seeds are not sown, then from where will come the new creativity? Don't expect that, right? So he can no longer understand a fantasy. Wo samajh hi nahi sakta, right? A fairyland, agar aap samjhao ki periyon ki kahaniyan, to nahi samajh aayegi usko. His brain becomes as soft as cheese. Aur brain itna soft ho jata hai cheese ki tarah. So as soft as cheese, which figure of speech is here that is easy to understand? Anyone can tell? As soft as cheese. Harshika, Vansh, Jyotsna, simple hai, comparison kiya gaya brain ka with the cheese. So it is simile. Simile when we compare the things with as. So as or as. Right? Is it clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
And you can see a fantasy, a fairyland. FF is repeated. Now you can tell which figure of speech here.
Ma'am, alliteration.
Very good. Here it is, alliteration. Fine. So it is very important that figures of speech should be clearly identified. So his powers of thinking rust and freeze. जो उसके thinking powers हैं, imaginative powers हैं, they rust. Rust, you know, iron पर लगता है when it is exposed to moisture and air.
Yes, ma'am.
So that is the forming of red and orange layer on the things. ये coating आ जाती है red and orange color की when it is exposed to, when iron is exposed to moisture and air. राइट सो उसका माइंड भी पावर्स ऑफ थिंकिंग क्या हो गई है रस्ट लग गया है ऊपर जंग लग गया है एंड दे आर फ्रीज्ड फ्रीज हो गए बिल्कुल दे आर नॉट इन अ मूवेबल कंडीशन ही कैन नॉट थिंक ही ओनली सीज वो देख नहीं सकता है कुछ भी द चाइल्ड इज डिस्ट्रॉयड ही इज रुइंड ही ओनली सीज ही ओनली वॉन्ट्स कि आप कर दीजिए सब कुछ एंड ही विल गल्प इट राइट सो ऑल राइट यू विल क्राई ऑल राइट ओके A poet is saying that all right, you will cry. आप ये कहोगे ना all right, you will say. But if we take the set away, now it is the point of view of the parents. What the parents are saying, कि but if we take the set away, okay, we follow your advice. We remove the television set from our home. What shall we do to entertain? So this is the most frequently asked question. कि what will be the source of entertainment for the kids if television is not there from where will come the entertainment our darling children our beloved children kahan se entertainment milega please explain you will have to give the solution also na we always say ki point out karna easy hai but you should also suggest the solution please explain we want the explanation we will answer this by asking you So poet says, the poet community is saying, ki we will ask a question from you. What use the darling ones to do? How use they keep themselves contented before this monster was invented? So what use the darling ones to do? Means what you darling people, my dear parents, what you used to do? This used is connected to this, used to do. What the darling ones used to do means jab aap log bache the, What you parents were doing? क्या करते थे हम लोग at school time? There were fixed hours for entertainment के half an hour के लिए TV में कोई serial and all we used to see. There was not any other source of entertainment. So हम लोग की habit थी we used to read a lot. I was in the habit of reading so much that I couldn't sleep. I didn't read any book at the night. And till now also I used to read one or two pages. Many novels I read and so many Shakespeare is my favorite actually. So I love to read about so many plays of him. So what use the darling ones to do? A question parents say ki aap log kya karte the? How use they keep themselves contented? And how you keep themselves? They means parents keep themselves contented. Contented means satisfied. Aap apne aap ko kaise satisfied karte the? Means aapka source of entertainment kya tha? Before this monster was invented, who is this monster?
Ma'am, television.
Television. So before the television was invented, आप क्या करते थे? You should let me know first. Have you forgotten? Don't you know? We will say it very loud and slow. So have you forgotten? भूल गए हो क्या आप लोग? Don't you know? आपको याद नहीं है क्या? Have you forgotten that? We will say. तो ठीक है. We will remind you. The poet community is reminding. वेरी लाउड एंड स्लो लाउड एंड स्लो स्लो इन द स्पीडली नहीं बता रहा हूं मैं एक एक करके आपको चीजें बता रहा हूं दे यूज्ड टू रीड वो पढ़ा करते थे बुक्स पढ़ते थे दे रीड एंड रीड एंड रीड एंड रीड नथिंग एल्स वी हैव ओनली द बुक्स बुक्स ये नहीं कि ओनली द एकेडमिक्स देयर वर कॉमिक बुक्स देयर वर मंथली आते थे बुक्स फॉर चिल्ड्रन एंड मैगजीन्स वर देयर And so many other things were there. So many variety of books. Because everyone's interest is on their own, right? It's not like that ki someone like to read history books, someone loves English literature, some other people are there who are more interested in maths or in the science. And now science ka meaning ye nahi ki only academics you are studying. You can also study about the scientist of whom you in whom you have a lot of interest. या ऐसा कोई राइटर जिसका आपको बहुत अच्छा लगता हो पढ़ना तो यू कैन रीड अबाउट हिज लाइफ हिज जर्नी ऑफ सक्सेस इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन स्पोर्ट्स यू कैन परस्यू और यू कैन फॉलो एनी ऑफ द स्पोर्ट्स पर्सनालिटीज एंड यू कैन लर्न अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स फ्रॉम देयर लाइफ्स राइट सो रीडिंग डज नॉट कन्फाइंड टू द अकेडमिक बुक्स ओनली इट गिव्स यू एवरीथिंग बुक्स में आपके पास बहुत सारी वेराइटी इट इज अप टू यू कि आप हाउ यू परसीव इट इट्स योर परसेप्शन एंटायरली And read and then proceed. और फिर आगे बढ़ते थे to read some more और फिर कुछ और पढ़ते थे क्या करते थे सिर्फ read and some more and then proceed to read some more और फिर कुछ और पढ़ लिया करते थे right? Then Great Scott किसके बारे में पढ़ा करते थे Great Scott ये सारे अलग अलग references हैं Great Scott cat soup see ये expression of surprises हैं right Great Scott cat soup One half their lives was reading books. Hamari half lives kis mein guzri hai? Reading books. The nursery shelves had books of books galore. Galore means a lot of. So nursery books par bahut sare books hote the. Nursery shelves par means since our childhood. First of all, wo primary hota tha. Primary mein A for apple, B for baby, bada bada bana hota tha. Right? Books cluttered up the nursery floor. When their nursery floor, yani jo baby's rooms hote in all, cluttered means filled up. Books filled up, cluttered means filled up, right?
Yes, ma'am, scattered everywhere.
Yeah, scattered everywhere also you can write. So scattered everywhere, the nursery book floors were filled with the so many books, right? And in the bedroom by the bed, and while before sleeping also we used to read the books, by the bed we had again other books were there waiting to be read more books were waiting to be read fir hum padha karte the such wondrous fine fantastic tales wondrous means wonderful full of wonders fine super fine fantastic are amazing tales are stories hairan karne wali kahaniyan hoti thi and we used to think about it because we do not have the images in front of us these were simply words which need to be crafted in images through our imagination right if you are describing a person with description you will have to make your own figures right so in this way fine fantastic tales again a figure of speech alliteration is there ff is repeating of dragons aur hum padha karte the kahaniyan dragons ki gypsies gypsies are dark skinned people jo travel karte rehte ghoomte rehte right queens ki kahaniyan Whales की treasure isles, isles are the islands. Treasure islands के बारे में पढ़ते थे and distant shores. Shores means the different countries. We used to read a lot these different places which explore a variety of imagine a variety of sources which are provided to our imagination. Where smugglers rode with muffled oars and pirates wearing purple pants and sailing ships and elephants and cannibals crouching round the pot. Stirring away as something hot. It smells so good. What it can be? Good gracious, it's Penelope. So, क्या क्या पढ़ा करते थे हम लोग smugglers के बारे में The stories would be dealing with smugglers. Smugglers जो अपनी country में दूसरी country से stock लाकर या stuff articles लाकर smuggle करते हैं They are smugglers. Rode with muffled oars. Muffled means not loud sound because of some obstruction, right? धीरे से आवाज में बात करते हुए ओर्स आर ब्लेड्स टू स्टीयर बोट बोट को स्टीयर करते थे दे आर कॉल्ड ओर्स सो मफल्ड ओर्स के साथ ऐसे टप मुंह को बंद करके स्मगलिंग किया करते थे वी यूज्ड टू रीड अबाउट देम एंड पायरेट्स पायरेट्स यू नो हु आर पायरेट्स दे आर आल्सो डिकॉयट्स
यस मैम स्पेशली दे आर फाउंड इन सीज एंड पायरेट्स गिवन टू देम बिकॉज़ ऑफ शीप्स ओनली
राइट सो डिकॉयट्स हु रॉब एट सी राइट wearing purple pants and they are described to purple pants pehante the and sailing ships and elephants and hum kahaniyan padhte the sailing ships ki the ships sailing from one end to another shakespeare has written a lot about that एंड एलिफेंट्स के बारे में सो मेनी एनिमल्स अबाउट एनिमल्स वर द मेन कैरेक्टर्स हमने वो भी पढ़ते थे एंड कैनिबल्स कैनिबल्स यू नो द पीपल हु ईट द फ्लैश ऑफ अदर पीपल मैन ईटिंग कैनिबल्स आर द पीपल हु ईट द फ्लैश ऑफ अदर मैन सो कैनिबल्स क्राउचिंग अराउंड द पॉट और पॉट ऐसे बना हुआ एंड दे आर कुकिंग समथिंग एंड दे आर जस्ट सिटिंग हियर क्राउचिंग एंड समवन इज बीइंग कुक्ड इनसाइड दिस पॉट स्टिरिंग अवे स्टिरिंग मींस मूविंग अवे और समथिंग दे आर मूविंग एट समथिंग हॉट कुछ हॉट वो पका रहे हैं इट स्मेल सो गुड और स्मेल इज अमेजिंग स्मेल इज यू नो इट्स जस्ट रीचिंग टू योर सेंस ऑफ स्मेल इज अमेजिंग यू आर जस्ट मेस्मराइज्ड टू सी द स्मेल यू नो वर्ड्स आर यूज्ड ऑफ सच लेवल that you are simply lost in the story and you feel like that it is all happening in front of you. So the guesswork will be what these cannibals are cooking. Oh, good gracious, it is Penelope. Penelope was the wife of Odysseus, right? Odysseus ki wife thi. And she used to be most sought after wife. Bahut craze tha logon ke liye. She was an ideal woman. And Penelope to cook nahi kar rahe kahin yahan par ye log. Because it smells so good. The younger ones had Beatrix Potter. जो यंग बच्चे थे वो बीट्रिक्स पॉटर की कहानियां सुना करते थे विद मिस्टर टॉड अनदर कैरेक्टर द डर्टी रॉटर वन मोर कैरेक्टर एंड स्क्वायरल नटके सो दीज आर ऑल कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ द फेमस स्टोरीज एंड पिगलिंग ब्लैंड एंड मिसेस टिकी विंकल सो ऑल दीज स्टोरीज वर रेड एट दैट टाइम सो दीज वर द मेन कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ द स्टोरीज वर दे they used to listen all about that. It is again the reminder to the parents that your childhood spent like this and you were exposed to a wonderful world of imagination. And what you are giving to your kids, this EDR box, who is serving them with senseless cartoons and stories and nothing else. Just how the camel got his hump. We used to study how the camel got his hump. The whole story is behind that. How the monkey lost his rump. Hump is the hind part of the body. Ye rump is mammal ka hind part, jo back part tha. Wo kaise rump usne lose kiya. Again, one more story is behind that. So you were blessed that you spent your childhood like this. And Mr. Toad, and bless my soul, there is Mr. Rat and Mr. Mole. So another character and Mr. Toad ke baare mein aapne padha and bless my soul. So you should bless my soul that I'm reminding you this all thing. There is Mr. Rat and Mr. Mole. Oh, books, what books they used to know. Wow, that was the world of books. Aisi kahaniyan aapne padhi hain. You know, you were provided with such wonderful variety of books, such quality books you read. Those children living long ago. And the children of the previous years, a few years back, children used to read all these wonderful stuff. So please, oh please, we beg. So here poet is saying, we beg, we request you, we pray you, please, oh please, go through your TV set away. Go throw your TV set away. So this is a humble request from the poet. You should throw away this TV set. So it is a polite request from the poet's side that this idiot box should not be installed in your house. You are simply killing your child's activities and imagination. And in its place, you can install a lovely bookshelf on the wall. And in its place, and in the place of TV, you make a lovely bookshelf on the wall. Wall par aap, जहां पर आपने टीवी लगाया जस्ट इंस्टॉल दिस बुकशेल्फ देन फिल द शेल्फ्स विद लॉट्स ऑफ बुक्स ब्रिंग अ लॉट ऑफ वैरायटी ऑफ बुक्स राइट एंड इग्नोरिंग ऑल द डर्टी लुक्स डोंट पे अटेंशन टू द डर्टी लुक्स दिस डर्टी लुक्स विल बी गिवन बाय द किड्स व्हेन यू विल टेक अवे द टेलीविजन सेट फ्रॉम योर होम देन डेफिनेटली यू आर गोइंग टू रिसीव द डर्टी लुक्स फ्रॉम योर किड्स But just ignore them. Don't pay attention to that. The screams and yells, the bites and kicks. Definitely they will be screaming. It is well expected reaction from the kids. They will definitely shout. They will scream. They will yell. They will shout back at you. The bites, they may bite you and they will even kick you. They may even kick you. But don't pay attention to that. And children hitting you with sticks, fear not. And here it is the hyperbole again. exaggeration है. The kids can never do this, I am sure.
Already, yes, ma'am.
They are not like that. They will hold the sticks ki mama ne phone le liya, so they are going to hit her with something. It's not like that. This is the hyperbole again. So children hitting you with sticks, but he is taking the actually the extreme level he is considering. If the matter reaches to this level also, please don't lose your heart. Don't change your decision. If you have decided to replace the television with the bookshelf, go ahead, do it. Ignore all the stern reactions that you will be receiving from your kids. Fear not. Don't fear. Don't feel scared, because we promise you that in about a week or two, or having nothing else to do, they will now begin to feel the need of having something to read. And once they start, oh boy, you watch the slowly growing joy that fills their hearts. So because you can connect it with the present scenario also. In the starting, when lockdown was announced, we were feeling like, how will we sit back at our homes? It was simply looking like a punishment. We were thinking like our life will convert into a hell, isn't it? We were thinking like that. But now, because of the corona crisis, we have developed this habit of living at home only, because we know at home we have life and outside we are going to be grabbed by something that won't be in our favor, isn't it?
Yes, so ma'am.
Happens, we get used to after things. In it, obviously, a change is difficult to accept, but change is the law of nature. So just change it. Fear not, because we promise you that. The poet is assuring the parents that in about a week or two of having nothing else to do, because they will not be provided with any other option, then they will now begin to feel the need of having something to read. So they will be feeling that now, because we have no other thing for us to read and to entertain ourselves, they will be only going to read the books. Chahe wo unwillingly pick kare, but they will pick it and read it. Right? And once they start, and once you develop this habit, once you start reading, it slowly converts into a habit of reading. At the start, you can be starting with some of the lines, maybe some of the pages, but slowly it merges into your habit so nicely that you feel yourself unable to go ahead without it. So once they start, oh boy, oh my dear, once they start, you watch the slowly growing joy that fills their hearts. You will feel that they are getting their happiness into it. They are getting maximum of their happiness in reading the books only. They will grow so keen. They will wonder what they had ever seen. So wo itne keen. Keen means desirous ho jayenge. They will become so desirous of reading the books. They will wonder, wo sochenge, that they had never seen in that ridiculous machine. Ki what they had ever seen? Arey, humne to kuch kya dekha? What they had ever seen? Kya bakwas dekh rahe the? What the rot we were seeing? What the rubbish we were watching in that ridiculous machine? Ridiculous, that is mockingly useless thing. Inviting mockery, that nauseating, foul, unclean, repulsive television screen. You can see four adjectives have been used by the poet. He has addressed television as nauseating. Nauseating means causing a feeling of disgust. Humiliating, right? Bahut hi humiliating hai ye. Because you are watching the things which are done by others. It is not giving you any chance to do anything on your own. Right? Foul, offensive to the senses. If you are not in the habit of listening to bad language, but if that particular language is used in a particular series that you see or any movie that you see, we are bound to see that, na? Though we don't like it, I personally don't like this nonsense, kind of comedy, this Golmaal kind of movies they provide. I hate that. But if it is going on in the screen and we are sitting in front of it and some kids are watching, or anyone of my family member is watching, I'll have to see that. And for with that, I'll have to listen to that foul language also, right? Unclean hai. That is not sure ki the stuff that has been provided to us, it is a good stuff. Repulsive means arousing intense distaste or disgust. We never liked it, but we'd have to see, right? सो वंस दे वुड रियलाइज कि हम क्या देख रहे थे, वी वर जस्ट किलिंग आर आर enthusiasm of doing the things. We were killing our imagination. And later, each and every kid. And the poet is very sure ki later, as the time will pass on, and the kids will develop the habit of reading, every kid will love you more for what you did. So everyone, each of your kid will love you more. They will develop more respect for you, more regard for you for changing their habits. What you did, what the parents did, what they did?
Ma'am, they exchanged the television with the bookshelf.
Very good. They brought the books in the house and they just expelled the idiot box from the house. Is the poem clear to everyone? More figures of speeches are there. Now, some I have marked, some are in the homework for you to do. Mark it in the next class, we will discuss that also, right?
Okay, ma'am.
You can revise it, and now I'm giving you the DPP also for this, right?
Okay, ma'am.
Right, so this is the DPP for you. Right? First one, first part, and this is the second part. Three extracts are there. You need to solve them. We'll discuss them all in the next class. Right? It will be sent to you through mail also, and you can take a screenshot of this also. Right? I hope you enjoyed today's class.
Yes, ma'am.
Sure.
Yes.
Ma'am, please show passage 2.
Yeah, I'll show you that also. This is the second one.